If you're a gamer, you want to play your favorite artist, GameStar app. Mama Silvers, what's up? Shout out to Fan Mia. Get the iPad and check it. Ciroc. I'm much finer, Vodka. Fan Mio, if you want to talk one-on-one with your favorite artist, it's the big show. Yo, Richie, what's up, baby? I see you out there in the L.A. Gina. She is not playing. She's part of a woman empowerment generation to where she said, next time you meet with Diddy or anybody about this show, I need in on the table. I am the executive producer. And I agree. Shout out to everybody that voted. Primaries was major today. New York, everywhere else. Kentucky. Kentucky's that. That Mitch McConnell, boy. We need that boy out. Gone. Be gone. Scootalulu. D.D. Barber, what's up? My favorite aunt. D.D. Barber, I just wrote a chapter yesterday about the family and how we love to gamble. Not me, because I don't gamble. Tony Sunshine and how I used to watch y'all. So it's talking about gambling, number spots. And I had a nice, beautiful segment there for one of my mentors, somebody I really, really look up to, is my Uncle Fayo. So, yep, Fayo will be in my book. Mama Silvers, what's up? Yeah, you know they all want to gamble. Come and see that. You know how that go. Let's see. Now I got a huge guest today. A huge one. Yeah, it's the big show. And you don't know who I know. You know, today Obama came out. Joe Biden co-signed him. Same place, fundraiser. We got to get out there and vote. It's the only way we're going to make a difference. If you stay home, you don't register, you don't vote, when it happens again, you're going to be feeling real crazy. Real crazy. Shout out to the BX on the check-in. You know, so we here. This is the Fat Joe Show, the big show. Yesterday, we had a huge show with my guy, Corey and his attorney, Brittany. So they This woman blew my mind. Oh, you in Miami, Tone? We'll connect tomorrow. You know, Lindy Official, what's up? Yeah. Nah, I mean, Corona too real. Everywhere we look, Arizona, everywhere we look, Arizona, Miami, where I'm at, Florida, big numbers. It used to be like 300 cases a day. Now it's 3,800, 3,200. It's real. Take it serious, Tone. Don't, you know, like you've been with the mask at and everything. Brittany Garnett, man, she's amazing. 51-0, man. She saved so many lives. And, you know, and people who deserve a second chance, you know, who society cast it off and they went back and did 20, 30 years and graduated college and passed every program you could have, you know, just some people who feel like, you know, who deserve a second chance. Yeah, keep that mask on, Tone. Hold up, let me see who's here. See my guys here. I see Lindy Official, very active. You know, and we just said, yeah, Brittany Barnett, man, she the truth. You know, and shout out to DJ Khaled, Nicole, and Acid, and Alarm, and we've been really, really, COVID is far from alive, bro. Like, you're playing yourself, and the problem is us as Americans. You know how we always want instant gratification. We want results now, and even when it first happened and they made everybody stay home, I couldn't believe everybody was staying home. That's why I started this show, to just tell everybody, chill, stay home. Now that they let a door swing open, you could forget it. I seen videos of Harlem, 30,000 deep, everybody, you know, shout out Pristine Jewelers. So what I was saying was, shout out to Khaled, because he's the only one besides myself who's been quarantined like me. So I'm able to go to his house and chill with them and really, really, you know, chill with family. You know what I'm saying? One of my best friends and his family, you know? I love the little baby Alarm. I love Asad too, but the little baby, he tough. Alarm is tough. Hold up, let me see what's going on. Tone Sunshine, I see you on the check-in. Without further ado, this is In the Game. The big show. Yo, Lou, you got some incredible Wi-Fi.
I'm working on it. I'm sitting outside on the rooftop, so I hope it don't go in and out.
Nah, you look great right now, boy. You know, they be coming on here with the crackhead Wi-Fi. I'm like, rich guys too. I'm like, damn, what's up with the Wi-Fi?
Cause they got rooftops, correct? You know how it go. They got rooftops and big basements.
I'm always on my rooftop too.
Yeah. What's good though?
Lou Will, Sixth Man of the Year every year.
Yeah.
It's you and Jamal Crawford, right? Like y'all. We would consider y'all the greatest six. Who?
Yeah, we got three apiece, me and him.
Y'all the greatest six men of all time, right?
Yeah. So, yeah, it'll be either me or Jamal, depending on your style of play. You know what I mean? But Doc Rivers really get the credit, because out of the six that me and him got, four of them is Doc's. You know what I'm saying? So it's really Doc Rivers. You know what I mean?
You know, I love Doc. Doc always looked drunk. I don't know if it's just me, but when I swear to God, my whole life, before you ever played for him, let's move you out of the equation. Doc looked drunk to me every night. I don't know why. I be like, looking at Doc, I be like, oh, he about to lose it. He about to lose it.
I ain't never seen Doc take a drink, bro. I think he just be geeked up. He be turned the fuck up. I never seen him take a drink.
Yeah. He's a stress case. He be like... Yeah. Forever. Right. He's one of the greatest coaches in the world. But that's an attribute to him that both of y'all You know, he coached 4 out of the 6 men right. of the year. So he must instill to you, like, because everybody know you're good enough to start on any team.
Right.
You know, and have you, I'm sure you felt like that, right?
Of course. Of course. You know, but, you know, in this business and in your business as well, everybody has a position to play, especially when you're doing something for the team. You know what I mean? And so once you start looking up at the head seat, you start worrying about the one that you got and what you can do for the group. So I had to deal with that early on in my career and just accept my cards. And so it got to the point for me where I said, you know, if I'm going to come off the bench, then I'm just going to make this shit look embarrassing. Like, I'm going to average 20 points a game off the bench, and I'm just going to make it difficult for second units. You know what I'm saying? And so for me, I was just I became comfortable in my skin, and I created a lane for myself where, like you said, it's either me or Jamal. Like, we're not in a crowded space. You know, we're in a special, we like special teams, you know what I'm saying? And so I enjoy the route.
You know, that boy Jamal Crawford got that crossover, man.
Yeah, see, like I said, it's gonna come down to your style of game, because Jamal, yeah, he's flashy, he gonna cross you, do all of that, you know what I'm saying? He got the crazy dribble game. He got all of that. And me, I get straight to business. You know what I'm saying?
You know, so, I never watched a Jamal highlight film, but he definitely made bobbleheads out of a lot of people. Like, sure. You know, he got that smooth back crossover wing. He got that.
Yeah, he
shit,
just
man.
Got that bounce. Yeah,
and
he
you
got
just
bounce.
Got everything. So
he
like,
just, I just
you,
get straight to it.
Well, you got everything. You go to the basket, yeah, you sure. Shoot the three, you shoot it. You got everything. Right?
Appreciate it, big. Appreciate it.
Who you emulated your game behind? Who was your inspiration coming up?
AI was my guy. You know what I'm saying? He the reason I got tattoos. This motherfucker the reason I got cornrows now with the quarantine. You know, he just was one of those people that I can look at him and I can relate. I just felt like we connected, and then it was a blessing for me to get drafted. And then we were teammates for 2 years. And so just for him to embrace me, be a big brother, and to be able to develop a relationship with him and not even knowing him before that, you know what I'm saying? It changed the course of my career just knowing him. But AI is definitely my inspiration.
You know, AI, one of my brothers, you know what I mean? Like, we family, you know, I went to his wedding. You know, I used to hang out with AI every day, drive down to Philly, hang out
okay.
with him every day. And it was an honor. One of the craziest stories, I got a lot of them that I can't talk about, but one of the craziest stories about AI is one time I took him out, we went out. And the thing is, I used to be with him every day, so the coaches and all that knew he's hanging out with Fat Joe the rapper, right? Like that much. So we went out one day, knew where we got so smacked, so drunk, to New York. We wind up going to my man's house in the Bronx. I'm talking about the bummiest apartment you ever seen in your life. We got a drop top Bentley outside. We so drunk we fall asleep there.
Yeah.
Wait, I'm talking about in the bummiest hood in the world, right? And we woke up in the morning. I was like, holy shit. He played against the Knicks the next day. I said, they are never going to let me hang out with Allen Iverson again in my life. Like, it's over, because he was vomiting all night, all morning. Man, that guy played the Knicks. I went to the game. He dropped
he was just fine.
50-something, 60 points on the Knicks.
Right. He was just fine. He a special breed, bro. He a special breed. Like, he was able to balance partying and all of the injuries that he had in his career, too. You know what I'm saying? Like, this dude was playing with broken bones and everything, and he still was him. He still was him. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you know, he
my big dog.
He had the heart of a lion. You know, although he came in small package. You know, big boy in small package.
Right. Heart. He got heart of a lion, bro.
Heart of a lion. There's no doubt about it. The only person he didn't want to smoke with, because you know he fought like – your RA, he fought like Mutombo, and like he was fighting big guys in the locker room, like one-on-one.
Yeah.
Like, and I used to try to gas him when he was playing the finals against the Lakers. I'd be like, yo, you need to dunk on Shaq, man. You need to dunk on Shaq. So I kept bothering him, right? And Shaq, my dude, and he looked at me one time. He said, yo, bro, Shaq gonna catch me in the air and throw me in the stands, bro.
No layup zone.
You trying to get me hurt?
Yeah, see, Shaq had this shit called a no layup zone. So don't even go in there playing with Shaq. Don't even go in there. Shaq fucked me up one time because I thought Steve Nash fouled me. This is at the end of his career. He was with Phoenix. I thought Steve Nash had fouled me, and I got frustrated. They didn't call the foul. So I just pushed Steve. And the next play, Shaq, I go down the lane, and Shaq just takes me out of the air and just pushes me. And he say, don't fuck with my point guard. I looked at him, said, yes, sir, my fault. My fault, big dog. Like,
let me tell you something. Shout out my man Drop, Engineer Drop, Drop Beats. But I used to always, I had a studio I used to use all the time in Miami. And one day I walked up in there, I work every day, 8 o'clock at night, it's pitch dark. Pitch dark, black as night. And I walk in the room, and all I see is a shadow sitting in a chair. Mm. The biggest shadow ever seen in life. So I said, holy shit. They got me. This guy's about to kill me in this motherfucker. Like, I'm like, Jesus Christ. It's like the biggest shit. Stop. So I find a switch. I turn the light on. It's Shaq Diesel in there sitting in the chair. And this shit's so crazy. He had just got traded to Phoenix. He wanted me to be the first to know. I said, well, why you have to scare the shit out of me?
Why you had to do it like that?
You trying to fucking kill me? I could have caught a heart attack fucking with you, Shaq. Motherfucker, imagine you walk in the studio unexpected, Shaq in there in the dark. I was like, oh my God, I gotta fight this guy?
Yeah, shit, Shaq might scare you in broad daylight. That motherfucker's so big.
Shaq's big, man. He really, really big. So are you ready to play this season?
I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I'm keeping myself in shape. You know what I'm saying? I hadn't made an official decision with how this is going to go because, you know, like we mentioned before, this shit is a team sport, right? And I understand I have thoughts and views, but I represent a whole group of guys. You know what I'm saying? And so if the majority of the guys say, yo, this is what we're going to do, this is what we're going to stand on, then I'm all aboard. You know what I mean? And so whatever my decision to be, it'll be collective, you know. So, but I'm ready. I'm ready for whenever it kick off, you know, if it happens. So, we'll see.
You know what happens is, you know, we all, you know, a lot of us spend unwisely. You know what I mean? Right. I got an opportunity to get that money in a corona. And there's a lot of players that ain't been playing as long as you that don't got their money right.
Right. Yeah, I mean, we got a team, a lot of shit.
So it's a team effort. Shout out my mother. She's on the check-in. Shout out, mommy. Right. I love you. So Pat Beverly, mm-hmm. Do you agree with his tweet when he said, if LeBron wants to play, we all got to play?
No, I know Pat. So what Pat was saying is, if LeBron going, we going. Ain't shit sweet. See, that's what Pat's saying. He's not saying, like, LeBron is the boss and everybody got to follow LeBron's lead. That's not what he's saying. He like, yo, if Bron is going to play, the Clippers going to be there because he ain't getting nothing sweet. That's Pat. See what I'm saying? People got to know that. And then once people put that up there, they're going to interpret it however that they read it. You know what I'm saying? But I called my brother. I said, yo, what are you trying to get across? Because I feel like I know you. And he said, bro, you know what I'm saying. You know what? I'm on some competitive shit. You know what I'm saying? And so
now,
that's
what
he
said. We see that in Pat Beverly. He's another little lion. He's a lion.
Yeah. Bro. But see, now that I explain it to you like that, that matches up with his brand. That matches up with what he about. You know what I'm saying? And so he wasn't saying, like, LeBron is in control or nothing. He basically saying, we're going to be there, too. If it's up, it's up. You know what I'm saying?
I feel him on that. And my thing is, when you go back to even the MJ days, they always had complaints. Yo, you breathe on MJ, you getting fouled, you get like, you know, the greatest of that era always gets a little leverage.
You know, deservingly so. Deservingly so. Listen, we got basketball related income. Outside of the contracts, we split the money equally at the end of the year. We understand who drives the business and who puts the seats in and who sell the jerseys. You know what I'm saying? And so, rightfully so, LeBron is the king. He's one of the few people that's earned a real nickname. You know what I'm saying? And so, with that being said, we feel like we got a great opportunity to do something special, like they felt like they had a great opportunity to do something special. And so,
you know, hopefully that's... Do you feel like this is y'all chip this year? Y'all get back to play?
I do feel like this is our opportunity. I feel like we have a great window, and this is the start of it.
So, I mean, you guys, I've never seen a team more stocked up than you guys. I don't even know how it's legal to do the shit y'all did this year. I'm gonna be real with you. You got
now Morris, we put together a group
game from the Knicks. He was dropping 40 with the Knicks, 30 something. You got what's my man from Detroit?
Reggie Jackson.
You ever looked at the fucking team and said, yo, this is out of control? Like,
now we got legit two-star lineups, and we feel like our other unit can be some starters in the league as well. Like, we're an extremely deep group, and we mature as hell, and we understand the moment. You know what I'm saying? We understand the moment. And so, you know, unfortunately with the corona shit, it slowed down the momentum. I would have loved to see how the playoffs was going to play out organically and how everything happened. And now we got corona, and then we got, you know, social injustice. And, you know, to be a person of color in this country right now is just, it's exhausting. It's a lot to deal with. You know what I'm saying? So, we're just trying to use our platform in the best ability that we can to maximize everything for the fan experience and also get positive messages across to the world. So we'll see if we can work it out.
Man, let me tell you something. It's always been bad for Black people, Latino people. It's always been bad. And what we're seeing on TV is just voiceless people who've been harassed and brutality, and they finally came together. And now their voice is that big. So we got to seize the moment, you know, and get some things done. You know,
for sure.
What did you think when you saw the, you know, the I've been trying to lighten it up, but when you saw the George Floyd tape, what ran through your mind?
I was bothered. You know what I'm saying? And I think what bothered so many people is just the lack of respect that they had for him. You know what I mean? It was, you know, people get shot and you see shootings and we kind of desensitized to that. But we never really just seen a person get choked out and you watch their life go away in a matter of minutes. You know what I mean? Like, we watch violent movies with a lot of shooting in the shooting scene. So we kind of desensitized to that shit. You know what I mean? And we watched that brother had that knee on his neck for damn near 9 minutes. And I think that struck a chord with a lot of people, man, with a lot of different people. And the world stood up. The world stood up for George Floyd. And on top of that, Stack 5 is our brother. He's our NBA brother. He's my man in real life. And so him having a relationship with that gentleman, that brought it closer to home for us. You know what I'm saying? That made it real. That made it personal.
You know, Stack is my brother since day one. When he had 10-day contracts. He used to play with Steph Marbury in New Jersey. And he would hang out with us all the time, man. He's a beautiful person, man. He's a great person. I love what he's doing. He's making it his business to not forget what's going on and to stay. Shout out. Well, we know we had Aubrey, we had Breonna Taylor.
Of course.
So much happened at the same time. And what do you say about voting?
I would encourage people to vote local, right? So I got schooled on voting locally because recently I was in my front yard playing football with my daughter, and a lady and her family, they pulled up, and she kind of approached with caution, like, can I get out the car and speak to you? And I said, sure. And so she walked up. She introduced herself. She said, listen, I'm running for superior judge in this county. She's a Black lady. And for and that interaction made it, it brought it closer to home for me, because I said, yo, I live in a predominantly white community, and here is an African-American lady running for judge in my county. You know what I mean? And so if we vote people in that have like mind, that have likewise minds, that think like you, that look like you, that feel like you, and you guys share the same ideology, and that person can possibly be in control of your county, I can only imagine that person is going to appoint a sheriff or a deputy, somebody in control that can police the community in the appropriate way. And so for me, voting locally is huge. I'm blessed to be in the same city with Killer Mike. So everything Killer Mike says, I listen to him. You know what I'm saying? He's an OG to me. And so he puts politics and organizing in a language where I can understand it. You know what I'm saying? And so I want everybody to go out and vote local, man. Make sure you put people in office that look like you and feel like you.
So Obama came out today with Joe Biden.
Okay.
Right? So, I mean, we got Biden, we got Trump.
What do you do? Like, you understand, you know exactly what you do with one.
Yeah, I know. I'm going for Biden, 1,000,000%.
Yeah, it's just, we got to get this guy out of here, man. It's just, I've never seen our country so divided, bro.
Never. Not in our lifetime.
Yeah, because they,
you know, in the 60s, you know, was worse. The 60s was worse. Yeah.
Right, but racists, right. So now in our lifetimes, racists are, they living out loud comfortably. Because they feel like they have a voice. They feel like they have backing. They're comfortable. We got to get that shit out. Yeah, we got to get that out.
Let me tell you something, man. This is a weird, a real, real weird, weird time. You know, Kobe Bryant, your interactions with Kobe.
Big homie. Big homie. I wish I played with Kobe. excuse me. I wish I played with Kobe earlier in my career. You know what I'm saying? Like, I played with him his last 2 years when he was on his way out. I wanted to play with him when he was in his prime. I felt like that would have did so much for me, bro. You know what
was
I'm saying?
Was he kicking the game to you? Was he schooling you? He looks like he's a coach beside the coach.
Yeah, like, at that point, he was so far, like, ahead of everybody that it was a certain level of competitiveness he just expected from us. You know what I'm saying? And so I wanted to be with him when he was giving out game, when he was like, yo, this is what we need to do, X, Y, Z. By the time we got him 5 championships in, he like, yo, if y'all don't understand this shit, we ain't gonna be shit. You know what I'm saying?
He lost his patience by that.
Yeah, his patience was up with us by then. We was a young team. He wasn't in the mood for trying to teach guys. He was trying to win.
You know, I always loved Kobe. I always loved this game. I only met Kobe Bryant one time. And
wow.
I was at...
How is that possible? You joke crack. How is that possible?
I seen him at a bunch of games and said like that, but never like chill with Kobe Bryant. And because, right. You know, Kobe really didn't used to chill.
Right.
You know what I'm
right.
saying? So you played with him, so you know, but... In any case, I'm at a Beyonce concert in Cali, the Orange Bowl or something. So Cali had brought me out to perform. So we leaving, and truck pulls up, the window goes down, it's Kobe and his wife.
Mm-hmm.
And I seen him, I ain't gonna front for you, Luke. I was like, yo, Kobe, I need to pick. Like, I mean, like.
I gotta have it, yeah.
Instant. Like, nothing to say. I already knew. I haven't seen this man in 15 years outside, courtside. I need to pick. So, faster than I said that, his wife hit him like, it's Joe Crack. That's the Latino. Like, show him the love. She jumped out and took the picture. It was me, Pat Poos. My man Preston Remy, and we caught that picture, but I was just so, you know, he was something else, man, Lou. Like he was beautiful, man. He was something to watch, man.
For sure, man.
He was something to watch. And
man, listen. Dog was so special, bro. Like his when he walked in the room and when it was time to play, his energy was different. Like I watched him. one time we was playing Denver, and Will Barton was going crazy. Will Barton got like 25 at halftime. So we come in the locker room at half, and Byron Scott is our coach. So he start drawing up some shit to make some changes for Will Barton, like to change our strategy. And Kobe said, "Don't worry about it, I got him." And so we all look at him like, "Yo, this motherfucker cooking. Like, he cooking, OG. Coach, I got him. Don't worry about him. I'm just going to make him not exist from the game." And Will Barton had 2 points the rest of the game, bro. That was the most amazing shit I seen, because everybody knew him to be a scorer and to be a prolific scorer like that, but he took that challenge like, not on my watch. And we ended up winning that game. You know what I'm saying?
That boy was – that boy, he was cold as ice. I was really mad at him when MJ made the comeback. And we was there in Atlanta at the All-Star game.
Okay. Hey, so, Craig, I'm not Kobe the only one. I have the same story. I was in 10th grade in Atlanta, 2003. And it's MJ last game. It's my first time being at an All-Star game. So everybody got on Jordans and shit. It's like it's a Jordan tribute. And he hit the fadeaway on the baseline, and that's supposed to be it. That's the fairy tale.
Kobe, go down Kobe, let him win. Cole come back and run it up.
Man, I was mad at Kobe for years. I was hot with him for years after that.
Yo, I was mad at him for years because I'm like, yo, man, MJ could have had that fairy tale, but no.
Yeah, here come man. Kobe. Not doing. He not going for it.
Let me ask you a question. Your top five favorite rappers of all time.
Top five favorite rappers of all time. Man, that's tough. Lil Wayne 1 and 2, because he got so many styles. So I'm gonna give him top my 1 and 2. I'm from the South, so Rosé was big to me growing up. Meek Mill is my brother. It's my right-hand man. So Meek could go in there. And, you know, like I said, I'm from the South. We really wasn't up on Jay and Biggie and everybody. And so I was able to catch Jay when I was a grown man. You know what I'm saying? And so Jay is definitely, that'll be my top five. Wayne twice, Meek, Rosé, and Jigga. You know what I'm saying?
That's a mean top five. So when Meek was going at Drake, was you worried for him, or you thought he'd come out on top? Like, where you was at with it? Was you arguing with motherfuckers in the gym? And like,
yeah, it was a difficult time for the Chasers, because Meek was on tour. That's what a lot of people don't understand. And you know how I get on tour, like you focused on that. You know what I'm saying? And so I really wish, just at that time, competitively, he could have been sitting down, Drake sitting down, and they spar it out. You know what I'm saying? I would have liked to have seen it happen like that.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest with you. I don't think I ever said this, but I thought Meek Mill would win at the beginning. Just because I've been to Philly.
That's his background.
Yeah, Philly, background. Philly grandmothers come out on the corner and spit. If Fat Joe come in the hood, school teachers, grandmothers, crossing guards, everybody spit.
Battle right. Rats,
everybody, old, young, right. Whatever. And so I thought, you know, he had the upper hand because of the environment, the culture of Philly.
For sure.
But for sure. Shout out Drake, one of the greatest of all time. Shout out to sure. The yeah. Brothers now.
More than anything, I'm glad they got back on the same page. You know what I'm saying? Because them guys had a real relationship. You know what I mean? And so I'm glad that it stayed competitive. It stayed in the right spirit, and everybody was able to come out and make some money out of it, make some money together.
That boy, Meek Mill doing a lot for the prisoners with the reform.
Shout out my boy. Yeah. He doing a lot. He doing a lot behind the scenes. He active. You know what I mean? He active for sure.
Let me ask you one more question. Your top five ball players of all time.
AI.
You could do it by position, or you could just do it.
Yeah, my five is AI, Shaq, obviously MJ, Kobe, and Penny Hardaway. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I got the four. Penny, my man, I love Penny, but I was riding with you with the four. That's my top five too. AI, Kobe, MJ, Shaq.
Right. I'm from Memphis though. You know what I'm saying? So I'm from Memphis. So for us, so Penny is Michael Jordan. He is Michael Jordan in Memphis. You know what I'm saying? So
no, he was incredible.
For sure.
He was incredible. I think the one I missed out would be Tim Duncan at power forward. Greatest of all time.
I would take Tim with KG's attitude. You know what I'm saying?
But let me tell you something. That boy got the work. He wasn't smiling. He wasn't talking. He just was getting busy. Now, you know what?
I got a guy. That's how Kawhi is.
I would make Tim the sixth man of the year. I just realized I ain't put LeBron in that top five. Like, I got to be smoking dope not to put LeBron on there. I just realized
Listen, it's difficult, Craig. It's a million of us. You know what I'm saying? Like for me, I can't realistically put Magic Johnson in my list. Like, when he was at the top, I was a baby. I'm 2-3 years old.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
saying?
I'm
coming right back. Don't go nowhere. Give me 30 seconds, please. 30 seconds.
What we got going in the comments right here? What's good? Underground, shout out y'all. Mel Maddox, what you doing with the hard eyes, Mel Maddox? What you got going on over there? What up, Shane? What up, Bugs? Straight up. ATL in here. What up, Chucky L? What up, Tom? Swan basketball in here. Getting them ladies together.
Yo, look. I'm sorry about that. I've been drinking so much water today, I had to run to the bathroom, man. You know, they tell you drink water. They said y'all Fat Joe was on commercial break in the big show. Yeah. Yo, Sav. Yo, Will, thank you for shooting the video.
Oh, no doubt.
Did you ever watch the video to finish Friday?
Oh, yeah, I checked it out. Y'all switched the song, though. Was that a different song? My bad.
It's song different.
Okay. You know what I'm saying?
We always give these niggas the tea, but we ain't giving them that tea. that's a crazy tea. But you know, you came through no matter what. Yo, Joe Crack, I come. And then you come. And I say, hey, all you got to do is flirt with this beautiful young lady here. I can do that, Crack. Nah, that's crazy.
My job is easy.
So I'm hoping y'all get back to it. You know, we greedy. You know, us fans, you know, we greedy. We want to see some basketball bad. I noticed that they try to get soccer back going. They try to get baseball back going. And they keep getting more cases of the COVID. Today, the tennis player was going for the chip. Djokovic, I don't know his name. He caught the COVID. No chip.
Yeah, I don't, man. If it's done right, it's just for us to make it happen. Craig, it gotta look right and it gotta feel right. You know what I'm saying? My concerns are 50-50 with the COVID shit, and the other 50 is, if I'm gonna sign up for it during these times, the social injustice message, it gotta be there. It gotta be authentic, and it gotta be right for us to stamp it. You know what I mean? And so,
you know, not to quote Austin Rivers, but I will. He had an interesting point. He was like, yo, we could play and donate some money to all the causes. Because, you know, money make everything move.
Right.
So I didn't take it like, you know, he said nothing wrong. And I also understand the other point of view. Damn if you do, damn if you don't. Because if everything was normal, this George Floyd thing could have been swept under the rug. Aubrey, under the rug, man. Be honest.
It's possible.
Being that we was all home.
You had to lock in.
It even woke up our white brothers and sisters. You got to understand, they've been privileged their whole life. They don't have the same type of interactions with the cops that we do. So when you telling them these stories, they looking at you like you talking foreign. But when they see it for themselves, they stuck at home, they like, wait a minute.
Right.
This is a fucking human rights issue.
Right. Yeah, and you know what else, man? We got about 6 to 7 weeks before we even scheduled to play a game. You know, who knows what it looks like at that point. My position was I wasn't comfortable with playing to this date. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wasn't fully committed to it because I just felt like we would be a distraction. You know what I'm saying? If our people are outraged and they in the streets and we got a big game at 7 o'clock, naturally you're going to try to, all right, let's get home.
No, I put that in a song already.
You know what I'm saying?
I said I'm on a yacht with some strippers talking about something social distance. I said, it's hard to stay woke when the Lakers playing the Clippers. I'm like,
nah, no bullshit. Nah, you know what I'm saying? Right. And so it's just, it like I said, it got to feel right and it got to look right for us to be in 100% full participation, man. So on one hand, we can unify people by being on the floor and giving people an opportunity to have some positive energy. Or another one is we don't do it and we keep fighting. You know what I'm saying? So at the end,
I'm going to be greedy and say, do the first and just donate some money. Yeah. I'll be greedy.
Well, the money going out anyway. I think
you know, once that game one start, it's like, yo, it's on. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like,
right.
You know, we addicted to the game.
Yeah, once we show up in Orlando, we're going to have our hard hats on. You know what I'm saying? And so everybody just got to do their part. I hope it work out. And we able to spark some change. We able to spark some justice, and some positive energy, man. So we'll see, crack.
All right, Lou, man. Thank you so much, man. You've been we've been so fortunate to have you on the show. We appreciate you. I think, and let me tell you, some Jamal Crawford's my man, but I think you're gonna get him this year. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna get that little.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Legacy, legacy.
Year, but that's my brother. Shout out Jamal Crawford.
For sure.
I know him since day one, man. He's a beautiful guy. But
you know
thank
what?
You for coming on the show.
For sure. Let me say this about Jamal and I check out. Man, that motherfucker is so supportive. And he's so, like, we've always been put against each other. And he's been nothing but a big homie to me, bro. Nothing but a big homie.
A
so salute
person.
Him. Yeah, so salute him. And appreciate you having me, crack. Ready to kick the shit, give me a platform. You know what I'm saying? I hope I gave these fans some real talk so they can kind of understand everything.
Real talk.
Everything that you're seeing on TV ain't what it is. You know what I'm saying? And so I hope they got some real talk.
God bless you, my brother. Thank you so much.
Love, bye. Crack.
Bye. You don't know who I know. You don't know who I know. Sweet Lou. Man, oh man. He gets busy. He gets money. That boy get busy on that dance floor, man. Lou, he just come in. He come right in with the strength. Raul T.S., what's up, my brother? Shout out Sad Jr. Man, I drank so much water today, I had to run to the bathroom. I mean, I understand, man. We so blessed because these guys, they take out the time every night to do a little interview for us. And we blessed, man. We don't pay these people. We ain't twerking. We ain't doing none of that shit. You know what I'm saying? So the fact that you guys come every night and support, I'm on it. I also know that, you know, a lot of people in the street already, whether we like it or not, a lot of people back to regular life acting like this corona ain't happening. It is. And God bless you. I wish you the best. I don't want none of y'all to get sick. But what I'm saying is, please try your best to be careful. Try your best to be careful. But let me go on and see. Let me pick a couple. I'm gonna pick about three. Shoot the fair one with it.
What's up?
So my brother, I can't see.
Hold on. My phone acting up. Hold on. Can you see me?
Nah, I can't see. Can't see.
Man, this crazy Android, man.
Yeah, man. It's crazy, my brother. You stay up, alright?
Hey, I'm gonna get a screen.
You know what? You know how that shit go. If we can't see your face, you know what I'm saying? We just don't. You know, we can't see your face. We can't do it. You know what I'm saying? Can't see your face. You can't do it. Goof. Hey, yo, Raul. Let me see. Funk Flex, I gotta reach out. You know what I'm saying? I gotta reach out. We need Kenny Sway to end the show. Yo, my brother, I gotta see your face. All right, I try to give y'all a shot, man. We got the dudes is acting crazy tonight. Yeah, this ain't going down like we wanted to. Yeah.
Yo.
Yo, what's up, my brother? How you doing?
Good, I'm chilling, man. This is an honor, man.
Where you from?
Name is Verse Reed. I'm from the Bronx. Boogie down, you already know.
Man, what's the luck of that, man?
Facts.
What's going on? So,
chilling,
so
man. First I look crazy.
That's your government name, or that's like you rap?
That's my rap name. Yeah, that's my rap name.
When your name Verse.
Yeah.
Spit 16. Your name Verse. You gotta come with it.
Yo. I ain't grew up on no picket fence. I'm from the X, born and raised with a vicious sense. Kaleidoscope filled with memories. Way to make it, made a wicked pen. Coming for the kid is premeditating your fucking end. No need to pretend like I be flipping packages. On my rapping shit with a hustle stuffing my mattresses. Your system's corrupt, so fuck your checks and balances. Fronting for the kid, a bunch of actresses. A galley king, probably take your bitch. Flow so sick, but gully on my Fredro shit. Make a call, watch them pesos hit. Shooters claiming that they bust online until they die. That's a halo flip. I bees that Bronx bully who don't give a fuck. Rather throw my hands to grab the nine or let that semi bust. Damn, your stock's plummeting King Verse. They not stomaching. I'm so raw. West now, they not fucking with me. Put your favorite rapper in a chokehold. Hit him with that stone cold. Little Spanish nigga, I be feeling like I'm Kodo. Bars never so. Bronx main school of hard knocks be my synagogue. Take it further than rap, then I'ma get your kin involved. The Iron Giant with the illest squad. Hey yo, watch this rap nigga get all up in them pockets. They hit one of my bros in marketing for some stock tips.
My brother, keep doing your thing. Never give up. Use social media because it's free, my brother. That's the Fox. Gem I'm going to give you now. Stay up. It's not the whistle. I'm not hitting him with the whistle. He's a good guy, you know? He don't get the whistle. Wow. There's a lot of people on this check, man. A lot of people on the check. And last one, then I'm out. The big, big show. Listen, UFO feed, cut it out. As the intimacy. Yo, listen, guys. Put God first. Tomorrow night, we're going to have a big, big, big guest on. You already know every day we try to outdo the day before, every day. Last night was incredible because my man Corey had 16. So imagine you get life in jail. This man has 16 separate life sentences. And shout out to Brittany. Attorney so passionate, she got him out of jail. God is great, guys. Imagine that, doing jail, 16 life sentences with no chance of ever coming home. And you still believe, and you still pray, and your lawyer fights for you, and hallelujah. You get sent home. Shout out Courtney. Publicist extraordinaire, the man, not the myth. Tomorrow night, I'm gonna give you a little hint. We're gonna go a little Latino tomorrow, but all the way there. So get ready, y'all. Peace, y'all. The big show.